President from United World Wrestling, Stan Dziedzic, is joining the press conference as well. I turn over to Peter Bacsa for some opening words, welcoming the international press to the World Championships.
Thank you very much. Mr. President, dear guests, so on behalf of the Hungarian Wrestling Federation and the organizing committee, I warmly welcome everybody to the occasion of the 2018 Senior Wrestling World Championship here in Budapest, in our beautiful country. So 5 years ago we organized a high level of World Championship, and we hope and we work hard to exceed those levels. And I'm very happy that so many media representatives came here to show and to air all over the world for championship. We have close to 400 media accreditation, so it shows that wrestling or beloved sport getting more and more interest. So I wish you everybody a good world, nice day, and a lot of success for your country. Thank you very much.
As competition begins at 4:45, I will just kind of give a brief on how the press conference would operate. We open the floor to the journalists' questions. I would ask to please limit it to two, and we go from there. Please, any questions?
Question for the president. It's footage from the BBC. There has been some people criticizing the draw, and as you have witnessed, in the 86 kilos, you had two of the best wrestlers going head to head in the first round, and you have a ranking system in place. Can you please explain how does that work?
I think that my vice president, Mr. Dziedzic, knows it much better.
Our question, so, and trying to make it not political, okay, I think our quest is to make certain that we separate the better wrestlers so that as the tournament advances, to make the tournament more attractive to the viewing audience worldwide. The best would be to have the best two wrestlers wrestle in the finals, the best two wrestlers, the next best in the semifinals, the next best in the quarterfinals. That's a very difficult task, especially when there's no practical way, given the language differences and the cultural differences, to do that in a forum where we can do it publicly. So we need to do it by setting a system of registration. And we have to be extremely careful. This is the very difficult part, because each of these countries, Iran, the United States, and Russia, have distinctly different methods of choosing their teams and of training and peaking for the World Championships. So we have to be very careful that we don't force these countries into this funnel that isn't best for them given their system. And so we have to be flexible enough to make sure that we end up with the four best wrestlers. And I think at the end, for me, now I'm speaking personally, I don't see how this championship, the results of this championship, number one and number two finisher in this world championship, can be the core of ranking the wrestlers for next year. This year we didn't have that event. We didn't have that opportunity because we changed the weight classes, going from 8 to 10, we altered some of the weight classes, so it made it more difficult. Hopefully going forward we can iron this out, because what I don't think anyone realizes is that whether you're number one or number four or number two or number three, it's almost identical. And there's just a couple, have 31, 32, or 30, 31, or 29, that's the only where someone would have an extra match. That's the only difference. So we need to establish a ranking system where we have room for the upcoming athletes, but recognize this championship's result as the foundation for the seeding of our athletes. And so I think we'll have some adjustments. I would rather have seen that match that you're talking about at 86 kilograms later in the tournament when the stands were full than I did as a first round when the stands were nearly empty. But yes, I think that's at the forefront of what we can do better. So.
And I would just add that we clearly announced 2018 when we start with the ranking system is an experimental one, and all nations are not used to that system. They don't really understood from the beginning that they have to practically the wrestlers have to take part in many Grand Prix tournaments. It's just the start. So we, as Mr. Gigi said, we have made some little adjustments in order to keep this tournament interesting. And please, don't immediately start with difficult questions because I have my new bodyguard. Where is he? He's down there.
Any more questions?
You get scared just on that question.
There's no more questions, and maybe I redirect the attention to the sporting matters of the competition. And I ask Marianna, how does it feel to be here in your home country as the former world champion in 2013, where you were victorious in Budapest? How does it feel 5 years later to, I think, compete in, I think, with the idea to repeat your performance in 2013.
Thank you. Köszönöm szépen. Óriási érzés újra itthon versenyezni. Én nagyon örülök meg, hogy újra sikerült egy ilyet véghez vinni a Magyar Vékonyzó Szövetségnek.
In the meanwhile, it's great to be here again, and I think that this is one of the biggest things for the Hungarian Federation, that they will be able to organize again this great event here in Budapest, in the Budapest Arena.
Ugye azt
mondják,
hogy én szülés után térek vissza a Budapest, és én nagyon szeretném megismételni a 2013-as teljesítményemet, mindent meg is tettünk ezért. Én úgy gondolom, hogy nagyon jó formában vagyok, azonban a versenytársaim azért másfél év versenyelőnyben vannak, úgyhogy ehhez képest én úgy gondolom, hogy ha maximum ki tudom kihozni magamból szerdán, akkor
még a terén élvény. I just returned to the mat after one and a half year of the best time in my whole life. Obviously, this is not an advantage in this kind of sport because about 1.5 years in this time, many things can be changed. But I think I'm in a good shape, I'm in a good form, and I think after the first two matches, when they will go on the way that I would like to see them, then I might be able to get a medal.
One more question and then we can conclude. All right, thank you.
Wait, I just want to say one thing that the press should know, now that Peter is one of our new Bureau members. I think when you asked your question about the, like seating, I think when we look at the makeup of the entire Bureau, to have the expertise of a referee. At one time, I think we had too many referees. But now we have this expertise of a referee that we need, that I think will make the depth of our conversations much deeper.
One question.
That concludes.
Вопрос Mr. Lalovic. Please, thank you, Mr. Lalovic.
just one question to you, Mr. Lalovic.
Mr. Lalovic, я вам хотел сказать, когда тренер что-то говорит, вокруг него негатив, что он нехороший. Точно так же, как и вы, я хочу, мы хотим за хорошую борьбу. Вот несколько вопросов. Я главный тренер сборной команды Польши по вольной борьбе, Юсуфу Саламу. Вот Париж чемпионат мира, это я как маленький, с 94 года я смотрю чемпионат мира каждый год. Это был самый сильный чемпионат мира, самый хороший чемпионат мира. Мы не можем тренировать все, не я один, все тренировали. Мы не можем понять, если есть полный зал, если есть хорошая борьба, зачем поменяли правила? Одно. Второе. Мы все тренера встаем в 6 утра. Сегодня мы все встали в 6 утра. Не успеваем ни завтракать, ни обедать, ни ужинать. Для чего это правило? Ни один тренер не согласен с этим правилом, который утром делаем. Потом, для... И спортсмены...
Excuse me, can we please get that
Okay, as far as I understood, so he's from Poland. He's the national coach of the Polish team, and he's in the system since 1994. But still, his question is, why would you change the rules of wrestling if everything is good and everything goes well?
Excuse me, 5 лет,
let the president answer
the question. Еще один вопрос. 5 лет работаем тренером, ни разу не было встречи с тренерами. Почему с тренерами ничего не обсуждаете? Только речаете в конгрессе, а тренерами мы работаем утром, вечером. Почему с нами не хотите разговаривать, общаться? Мы одна команда. Если мы одна команда, и ОМО, и федерации, и тренера, и спортсмены, почему нам нельзя вместе это делать? Почему без нас все вы решаете? Почему нет элементарного к нам уважения спросить, что как? Здесь тоже специалисты, здесь олимпийские чемпионы, призеры олимпиады и так далее. И зачем электронная жеребьевка? Зачем все усложнять? Можно же справедливо все делать. Мы 200, я как тренер польской команды, 230 дней в году на сборах, 230 дней. У меня 4 детей, я своих детей не могу видеть. А сегодня за жеребьевка непонятно, как, что, зачем, для чего это все нужно. Так получается, мистер Лалович, извините, конечно, так получается, что мы в этом цирке клоуны. Мы не хотим быть в этом цирке клоуны, мы хотим, чтобы борьба развивалась. Посмотрите элементарные вещи, то, что мы делаем. Утром сегодня, например, я борец, это болельщик. Сегодня утром должен болельщик прийти посмотреть на меня. Вечером должен прийти. Завтра утром, завтра вечером. Кто придет 4 раза билет купить, смотреть на борьбу? Никто не придет. Для чего это все делается? Например, в других видах спорта за 3 минуты продают билеты. У нас пустые залы. Я был чемпионом турнира Турции. Пустой зал там. Пустой зал в Дагестане. Пустые залы везде. Каждым разом зрители уходят. Потому что один день один борец борется, все придут посмотреть. А так здесь один борец борется 2 дня и 4 раза билеты. Здесь
Excuse me, sir. Can you please?
Это как спектакль, как спектакль.
Перевод дуже, перевод не можна, она должна привести никаким образом.
Sums up everything that we just heard in English. So he'd like to ask you, Mr. Lalovic, why are the head coaches and the coaches of the national teams from all around the Europe, from all around the world, why are they not involved in making rules and to create the changes and just talk with them? This is the
where the holes are full. He also said where the holes are full, why we change the rules? And then it was said that why we oblige them to go back to the hotel, have the lunch, and then anyway the holes are empty. A lot of inconsistency. I understood everything that was asked. First of all, on our Congress, all the nations are represented. 126 delegates attended the Congress. I believe that you should speak more in your within your national federations and instruct your delegates not ask the questions that has to be asked. There is a place to ask them, but there is also a coaches commission which works permanently and always open to any suggestion. The change of that rule that you just mentioned is the morning weigh-in. The morning weigh-in is to try to persuade all of our coaches to understand that wrestlers cannot lose 15, even 20% of their natural weight in order to be to go through the weigh-in and then compete in the way you do last 20, 30 years. We are very much concerned about their health. And this is the reason that the weigh-in is in the morning. If you have to wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning and compete at 10:30, 11, we think that, you see, this is the hotel where everybody is and where the breakfast is served. It's just through this window. So, I don't think that going to have breakfast at 1 minute and a half after the weigh-in is a big issue. Why don't you never say that you are ready to change your habits and to let your wrestlers wrestle in their natural way? Can you see the differences in the second bout, in some bouts where the wrestler had a lot of weight cut? It's terrible. You sometimes oblige wrestlers to wrestle in a weight class in which they cannot even live, not wrestle. And this is championship of wrestling, not the championship of weight class. And I think that this bad habit of the weight cut is creating all these problems. And this is exactly what we want you to change in your mind. Because one day somebody will be responsible for their health.
Thank you, President Lalovic. That concludes the opening press conference.
Good.